Hello, my name is David Meany, VP of Technical Sales and Marketing at ECS Inc. International. In this multi-part series, we will look at oscillator design basics. We will cover all the steps required to design and build a functioning oscillator. In this fifth episode, we will discuss the drive level and negative resistance. The drive level is the power dissipated by the crystal unit while operational. The power is a function of the applied current and is usually expressed in terms of milliwatts or microwatts. Crystal units are specified as having certain maximum values of drive level, which transform as a function of the frequency and mode of operation. Exceeding the highest drive level for a given crystal unit may result in unstable operation, including accelerated aging rates, and in some cases, complete crystal failure. The drive level may be computed by the formula shown. For optimum performance, an oscillator circuit must be designed in such a way to enhance negative resistance. This is known as the oscillation allowance. Evaluation of the amount of negative resistance in each circuit is accomplished by temporarily installing a variable resistor in series with the crystal unit. The resistor should be set initially at its lowest setting, preferably close to 0 ohms. The oscillator is then started and the output monitored on an oscilloscope. The variable resistor is then adjusted so that the resistance is increased while the output is continuously monitored. At some value of resistance, oscillation will be stopped. At this point, the variable resistor is measured to determine the ohmic value at which oscillation has ceased. Add this value to the maximum resistance as the specified by the vendor. The total ohmic resistance is deemed to be the negative resistance or the oscillation allowance. For good, reliable circuit operation, it is recommended that negative resistance be a minimum of 5 times the specified maximum ESR value. Values of negative resistance exceeding 5 times the maximum ESR of the crystal unit are even better. As negative resistance tends to decrease at elevated temperatures, it is recommended that the test be performed at the highest temperature of the operating range. Join us for our next video on oscillator transconductance, fundamental versus overtone resonance mode, and design considerations. As always, you can visit us on the web at ecsxtal.com. Thank you.